Welcome to my channel. Let's get this shit started. So here we go. I really wanted to start this video specifically talking that recycling is not dead. I feel like I have read many things out there that people are like, who cares about recycling? But at the end of the day, we still have to remember that we should be doing the right thing. And one of those things, the main thing, is reducing our waste, right? And before you even recycle. The second step is recycling, and recycling whatever you possibly can. Specifically for this video, I want to talk a lot about TerraCycle. But with TerraCycle, since they can just recycle so many different things, I wanted to touch upon beauty products and like vitamin recycling and things like that, because they do have a free program, I will link it to this video, that you can recycle those things. And the importance of it, kind of really where it stemmed from me, is that as a person who suffers from psoriasis for as long as I can remember, there's still a lot of products out there that are zero waste, that are not really suitable to my skin or my hair, my scalp, just because I have a very, very sensitive skin. And that has been also for a very long time. And kind of really going with that is, I do still use things that are not zero waste, and they are packaged in plastic, unfortunately. And as you probably already know, there are a lot of places that don't recycle cosmetics through your regular recycling center, which is a huge problem, right? Because you would think that those things would be recyclable, but a lot of them are not. And therefore, I will be sending off this beautiful box to TerraCycle. And I wanted to touch upon a few items that will be in that, and kind of why I still have them, or why I no longer will be using them, or, you know, really some of these have been in here, let's get real, for 3 years or so. So we're not perfect. So let's get started. So my first item, I'm gonna go with this one. This is the essential multivitamin for vegans. I still actually take these vitamins from Future Kind. Recently I saw, and I've only been really taking them for a couple months, recently I saw that they have diminished their packaging quite a bit, which is fantastic. This is, however, still plastic. This is the only vitamin I have found that I feel like really suits my lifestyle. I really do love it. This makes me avoid B12, which is actually in here too. This is my second item, B12. I no longer use this because when I originally got this, I thought this was in glass. It is not. This is plastic. And also, like, the squirty thingy, this was just not the best product for me altogether. I did not enjoy this. But because I wanted to replace this, and then instead of having like two different kinds of vitamins all in one, I feel like this is a lot less wasteful than just getting this all the time along with another vitamin. Too much. It's just too much. With that said, we'll move on to the next thing, and this is a triple antibiotic ointment. I'm not kidding you, I did pull this up. This has been expired for a decade, okay? Yep. 2009. No, my bad. 2014. Okay, y'all, it's 2020. I don't know. This is bad. So finally, I'm getting rid of this tube. They're actually going to recycle. You know, tubes are really, really hard to recycle. So we're going to just get rid of them altogether and not repurchase that. There's other ointments that are a lot better than this stuff anyway. Better. They don't use animals as testing products, which is a different subject for a different time. The Zerma E thing. So this is a vitamin C concentrated serum. I finally got the courage to get rid of it. One, I felt like this was pretty effective. This was my first vitamin C that I have used. I am happy to say that I have replaced it with a glass vitamin C I'm currently using, which is really, really exciting. Derma E is a really great brand. However, this is in plastic, and if you can find something that's kind of the same thing for me and it's not packaged in plastic, I'm more than happy to like replace that product. So, but regardless, Derma E is a really great brand. However, this is not something I'll be repurchasing. Ulta MD. Really love this too. Again, plastic packaging. This is the only sunscreen I have found yet to not irritate my skin. So this, I do actually have one of these right now in my cupboard again. It is in plastic and you can recycle this, you know, through your recycling center most likely. So I will be sending this to TerraCycle as well. Lip balm. The one I'm currently using right now is Meow Meow Tweet Tweet. I love it. It is so fantastic. It's a great company too. It's a great brand. And also, it isn't compostable too. It's wonderful. This BB, amazing brand, BB Beauty Blueberry Booster. I no longer use this because I just found this was a little bit too expensive for like the amount, and I was like slathering like all over my face and like my neck. So I won't be repurchasing, but it is in glass, and it's, you should be recycling this via TerraCycle just because of like all of this like packaging and the dropper. It's just, it's too hard to do it otherwise. I have two of these because they're the same thing, but Coco Kind. I do love this brand. However, this is in plastic, and also this contains coconut oil, which I find to be very clogging for my pores. I used to put this kind of like underneath my eye, although I did see really great results. I think it's too cloggy for me personally, and I have replaced it. I think the thing that I'm currently using is Velita, and it's been really, really fantastic, so. Here's that. One of the last things, second to last, this is a Schmidt's Charcoal and Magnesium. Jack still uses this because this is the only deodorant that works for him. It is packaged in plastic. I have a jar of it in glass. It is very annoying to use, I'm not gonna lie. I've been trying to do it, but we continuously keep buying these, but also we are sending this to TerraCycle to completely be recycled. Last but not least, this is a Maya Chia sample. The reason I wanted to show you guys this is because samples, right? I feel like people love samples. Like, I totally get that. But this is very difficult to recycle. Look how tiny this is. And this is a beautiful brand, by the way. It's really, really great. But it is hard to recycle something this small. And I feel like it's just so much easier for people to give it to you, almost like pawn it off to you if it's like a sample. Like, try this free sample. And it's like, the word free is like gratis. Like, we get this for free. That's great. I feel like the philosophy I've been trying to live in 2020 is to not accept samples and to kind of like avoid them altogether. And thanks to being locked inside for so long, I feel like it's been working out really in my favor by not like going to a store and getting a sample. But I think kind of going forward, I will no longer get samples because this kind of makes me sad. So I'll be hauling all of this up through TerraCycle. I'm very excited to do so. And I think that, you know, every step really, no matter how small, how large, really, really does impact us. And like, this is still a bunch of stuff that's not going into the waste stream. And I think that's really big. And because if you really take it into consideration, if 5 of us do this, right? Or like 10 of us do this, that's a lot of waste that we're just not throwing into landfills. And I think we should do everything possible to get there. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any suggestions for more sensitive products that could possibly replace some of these, especially the sunscreen, I'm all ears, I'm all for it. So do give me that feedback. Otherwise, I'll see you next video. Bye.